Well, hello. We're going to do another lesson. This one's going to be about crosshatching. Crosshatching is a technique that's been used ever since there was drawing, and it's just a matter of doing parallel lines and then kind of like on the grill, cross lines. So it's nothing really very different than just drawing parallel lines and then doing a cross hatch. And you can make as many different crosses as you want to make the area darker or lighter. And that is cross hatching. So today we're going to draw a sphere, and which is basically a circle, but once you add the shading and the light, it will turn into a sphere on a three-dimensional surface. So I'm just going to start off by drawing a circle the easiest way I can by using that cup. And I am assuming that the light source is basically going to be coming this way, like this. So that means there'll be a highlight here, there'll be a shadow here, and so we'll start. I'm going to draw a horizon line right here. I'll draw the top half of a square here. And then the bottom half of our square, kind of a rectangle, down here. Now, there's another thing, is like, artists don't necessarily have the ability to draw straight lines either. Everybody says, I can't draw a straight line. Well, and that means they're not an artist, but that's not true. Okay, excuse me. Here we go. Everybody has their own technique because their hand is their own hand, but this has been used by the masters for hundreds and hundreds of years. Just this simple parallel lines. This is part of what art is just patience. If you have the patience to do art, you can be an artist. And that's about the main requirement. Otherwise, the people that don't want to do it, they're not artists. And the people that want to do it are willing to spend the time to do it. I'm just going to continue this first series of parallel lines, kind of in these layers. Okay, now I'll start a crosshatch the other direction. Many famous artists have used cross-hatching and mainly as their main drawing technique. Morandi is one from art history. A famous contemporary artist is Murray Tinkleman, who was one of my instructors and mentors. And he would draw very detailed drawings in crosshatch. Now you do another different direction, like this. Okay, now there's going to be the lightest part up here, and it needs to have kind of taper into it, so it doesn't need to have a stark edge. It needs to be very gently blending into the crosshatch area. And no place is really completely white. But this area here is going to be the darkest. So it will get the most cross-hatching. Now the paper reflects back up, or the surface of the table, whatever this is, will reflect back up and make the edge of this down here lighter than the darkest part. This is just a regular graphite pencil, like you would write a paper with in school. Nothing unusual about it, no fancy. Just a mechanical pencil. I'm using a mechanical pencil just so I don't have to sharpen this pencil. It's a lot like watching grass grow, but this is cross-hatching. It is a time-consuming process, but it does create form, and that's what we're going for here, is turn this circle into a sphere. This is the darkest part right here, away from the light source. Now I'm just kind of feathering this out a little bit. Okay, now, again, here is the bottom edge, and like, the light is coming from here, so it's projecting a shadow that will go kind of like this. So, we'll make the whole area first, so we'll do our nice curved parallel lines here for the first part of our tabletop. Like I said, everybody's cross-hatching will be different. Some people are very, very strong with their parallel lines. Some people are more random. Mine are a little more random. But in the end, it'll have an overall quality of being shadow and surface. Now we're going to start the shadow part. Check this. Okay. Seems to be working. I'm trying to speed this up so I don't run out of time on my recording. Now this needs to be kind of softened on the edge here. Because it is a shadow, there's light is not a distinct edge. Marcus right under the ball. Okay, now I'm just going to make this a little less liney and a little more shade.